Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Resurrection Day. Every day is Resurrection Day. And we're glad to have you with us today. In just a moment, we're going to open with the choir's presentation of the Lamb of God. And then after that, we'll go into our communion time. And after our communion time, we'll go into our Sunday school presentations. So let's go ahead and ask the Lord's blessing in our heads. Good Lord in prayer, let's give him thanks. Lord, here we are. You've always known where we are and what our greatest need is, even before we knew that our greatest need was the perfect gift, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for giving him for us and his determination to do your will and to offer himself as the sacrifice for our sins. And in our acceptance and obedience to him, Lord, to receive forgiveness and your Holy Spirit in this wonderful fellowship we have here with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Thank you for the opportunity today to share. Would you bless choir as we share this message with the Lamb of God. Bless those who hear. May we strengthen them. Brought joy to God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Jesus Christ died for us and rose to live again. It's the message of Easter and the reason we need to praise him forever. But even before Jesus proved his love at Calvary, people who encountered him were talking about his kindness, his compassion, and his power to heal.
I've just been with Jesus. heart has been to Jesus, it will never be the same. Some see him in the temple, some have heard him on the news, some have even heard him at the
from the miracles they witnessed,
to the way he loved our children, everybody had a story they could tell. I just think of Jesus, and I'll never be the same. I just think of Jesus, and I'll never be the same. I will shout the praises
and bless his holy name.
I just think of Jesus, and I'll never be the same.
What a day,
I just think of Jesus, and I'll never be the same. I just think of Jesus, and I'll never be the same. I will shout his praises
and bless his holy name. So much history and sacred ritual were part of Passover. Through it, Israel commemorated that amazing night in long ago Egypt when the blood of a lamb saved lives and demonstrated both God's power and his mercy. The day Jesus laid down his life, he became the Father's Passover lamb, sacrificed for us.
No sin to hide, but you have sent him from your side.
To overcome his yielding sword, and to become a man. Give the love they crucified, they have been torn and as he died.
The humble king they gave the cross
and sacrificed the man of God.
Oh, Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I know your holy Lamb of God, who was in his righteous love, my Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. I was so lost, I should have died, but you have brought me to your side, to be the life you scattered on, and to be the Lamb of God. Oh, Lamb of God, we Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. Oh, what's he in his righteous blood, my Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Jesus, may you come, hold him in my heart.
How can we ever really understand the grace poured out on the world when Jesus died? We were sinners, without righteousness, without the ability to save ourselves, without hope. While we were in this desperate condition, God proved his love for us on a cross. Until the resurrection transformed into a day of celebrating and rejoicing, a day of gathering and remembering, a day of worshiping and singing. Since that first Easter, believers can't stop testifying about the empty tomb and the risen Lord.
Christ the Lord is sons of men and angels sing, hallelujah. Raise your voices and sing, hallelujah. deep and tender deep heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Less than total devotion to Him and to His kingdom.
I have heard every sound of the world run before a Zion's throne. They were told that He was saved. If they would renounce the name of Christ, the one God of God, they chose to die, the Son of God, they would not deny, like the great and terrifying choir. I can almost hear their voices ring.
And one by one, they will
The notoriously vicious Assyrians in ancient times took their captives home by inserting a hook through their cheeks of those captives. Keep up or else, as you are dragged along. In fact, many cultures, ancient and modern, marked their captives as slaves by a ring in a nose or ear. It was always a sign of an ultimate death penalty. And piercing of a different sort was common in ancient warfare. Knives, arrows, swords, spears, and axes. All were piercing weapons. When gunpowder was discovered, the piercings became even more efficient and possible at more than arm's length. The piercings were always designed to accomplish one objective, the death of the one pierced. Mary, on a joyous occasion of the presentation of her firstborn son at the temple was dedicated to the Lord, was given the sad piercing news, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. At the very moment, 33 years later, as a calloused Roman soldier pierced the side of Jesus on the cross, simply to assertion of his death,
A maternal sword of aching love and sadness pierced the very soul of Mary. And John, as he stood at the cross, watching the water of blood flow from the side of Jesus, could not recall and exclaim the words of Zechariah, "They will look on me, the one who they have pierced. They will mourn for him as one mourns for their only child, and grievely bitterly for him as one grieves for their firstborn son." Here we stand with visions of that pierced and bleeding body. Here we mourn for him as with our only child. Here we grieve for him as he was our firstborn son. Piercings are popular. Let every decade of piercing you see this week not cause your head to shake in disappointment or dismay. Let each bring your thoughts to humiliating and life-sapping piercings inflicted on the head and back and hands and side, the feet of the Lord who was pierced that we might be made whole.
As we come to our time of communion, you'll find the words to our communion song in your program today. I believe it's on the back page. And the very first line of our song talks about the piercing that we received beginning with the driving of the nail. May we remember him.
Go ahead, drive the nails in my hands, that may be from where you stand. Go ahead and save me, the day will come when you will see, cause I'll run. There's no heaven and I need out. Yes, I'll run. They can't keep me down. Go ahead and hold my hand. My love for you is still the same. Very soon, I will be free. That's how there's no power that I need now. Just how go ahead and say I'm dead, you will see that you were wrong. Thank you.
Beautiful song we just sang. I really love the back part of that song when it talks about he's coming back for us and there's no power on earth that can hold him back. There was no power at all that could keep him in that grave. He is the creator. He is the one that maintains our sun, our moon, our earth. He keeps us all going in the right direction. He is our God. He came, he died for each one of us. As we gather around this time, let us realize and remember what he has done for us. But also he asks us not just to sit here and listen and do the things we're supposed to, but as we go through those doors and go out into this world, that we need to know, people need to know who we are. We are Christians. And they will know this by our love. But people begin to see what inside, what the Lord is. But as we gather around this table, let us realize how important it was for him to come and die for our sins. Bless this table.
Heavenly Father, we want to take this time to thank you for the honor and privilege we have to be in your house and pray for us and grace. As we gather around this table, let us do this in a very pleasing way to you. Because, Lord, we know that you sacrificed your whole life for us, for our sins. And most of all, you came back to show us the way we need to go by following your word and your scripture. We thank you, Lord, for all that you have done. For this in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Thank you.
Lord, we gather here in your house to worship you. Thank you, Lord, for everyone that has came through these doors in your house, Lord. Lord, I ask you to have them come over. Lord, to worship you with us. Praise to you to our men and women that have been in our country, and it isn't as fortunate to be here with their family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
God is good. You may be seated. This time I'm going to invite our ladies from the ladies' class with Lynn. They have a special class for us, so I'll invite them forward.
And there's also one on the other side of the table.
How many of you can see yourself singing that Old Testament hymn when you were in the road? Right.
Red is for the blood he gave.
Green is for the grass he made, and yellow is for the sun so bright.
Orange is for the red of the night, black is for the sins we made. White is for the grace he gave.
Purple is for his hour sun.
Pink is for our new tomorrow.
A hand again for the kids, a hand again for the kids. Also, I want to thank several of the children who came up. How many of you got handed something this morning? Some of the kids. Anybody else beside me to get somebody?
I've got a couple of you.
If you didn't get one, I still have an extra right here. I want to thank again the Hotel Adventure. The Choir Adventure. Really enjoyed that today. And,
you did it. We're a bunch of hound dogs in the back room.
They got together. We've been together for the last, how many weeks have we been together? 5 or 6 weeks, I think. And, just appreciated the ones that said, hey, can we do something for Easter? That wasn't even on the plans. And I don't know if you could hear, there was accompaniment music and some voices in the background, but all I heard was our people singing. I was really blessed to be a part of that this morning. Thank you so much. And ladies, by the way, we're having choir practice too, if that's the deal with you. We're going to get together, just kind of relax and listen to something for, guess what? Christmas. All right. So, any other kind of relax? Anyway, also thank you, ladies. Are you working on the New Testament now? You're heading there next, I'm assuming.
For next season.
I mean, that comes next. That's great. I mean, you see yourself saying that way going down the road. But that was really catchy tune there. And thanks again to the kids coming up this morning. Every day is Resurrection Day for us. And when you think about what Jesus did for us on the cross, I don't know if you've given any thought. I drive down the road a lot. I cover a lot of miles. And sometimes I'll be heading down the road, especially on my road. Maybe those little squirrels out there playing in the road. I'll slow down and I'll honk and quit playing on the road. And the other day I honked at one, and just a cute little fella, scampered off in a couple hours. I was coming back down through there and he got run over the hill. Now, I don't want to do that for that. If I can, I pull over, I get him off the road. They never saw it coming. But Jesus Christ saw it coming. Jesus Christ purposely placed himself in the path of death, in the path of all the demons of hell, in the path of Satan himself. He purposely positioned himself, not only purposely, but perfectly positioned himself in the face of death when he died on the cross for you and I. And then 3 days later, which we celebrate every day, he emerged the victor. And so can you. You also, through death, burial, and resurrection. That's the baptism we experience when we die to ourselves and we become alive to him. We can experience the same victory. Amen. The Bible says when we're raised out of the water, we're raised to walk in newness of life. And we're raised in the likeness of his resurrection. Not just his death. And even as we gather around the Lord's table every Lord's Day from there on, from those of us that have accepted Christ, we proclaim his death until he comes again. So we're going to close with an acapella chorus. The words are again in your program. I believe they're on the inside. It's a medley of I pledge allegiance to the one who is Lord, the one who we decided to follow. God, I'd like you to stand with me.
We close our service. It's an invitation for you, should you desire to become a child of God today before you leave. Just as he died for our sin, we can die to sin, be buried with him, and raised to walk into his life. We always give that invitation to you. Now, bless the others that live for him. Also, we'll be remiss if all of us did not thank him, Bert on for that powerful devotion on Pearson. Pierce for our transgression. One night, one day, we're asking to see him, even those who pierce to God. Those are blessings of the day. Ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag with all my strength, with all my hand, I will seek to honor his name. I pledge allegiance to the flag. He is all. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back.
As a choir joins, verse 29.
I pledge allegiance to the land. With all my strength, with all my hand, I will seek to honor his name. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb.
Thank you, God. Thank you for the baby Jesus, born in an obscure town, a small town of Bethlehem. Crucified in the capital city, raised in newness of life, and one day coming for us. May we be ready, Father, for that day. And until then, Lord, give us the strength and power and the joy and peace to share his good news to those who need to hear what we know. Through Christ we pray.
Amen. Have a great day. Hey, forgot to mention, I'm sorry. One more quick. Nobody heard of you. Tonight, 6 o'clock. I'm sorry, we got to 6 o'clock tonight. Special movie event. Hey, everybody. Tonight, 6 o'clock, we're going to watch Facing the Giants. You have your attention, please. Attention, please.
Hey, guys.
I need your attention, please. For watching Facing the Giants. My favorite part of that movie is when the coach tells my boy, I just saw God work a miracle for you. I'm telling you, I look at you all and God work a miracle for you.
I'm like,
see you guys next. That's what they want to say.
I'm